service over to Brother Brooks Hartley. God bless, buddy.
Thank you. All right. How are y'all doing this morning?
Good.
All right. Give me one second. All right. Hoping this thing works. I'm not quite sure. I feel like I look like Hannah Montana or something up here. So hopefully this deals. All right. Well, all right, today, there's actually a lesson that me and Michaela did for her church at DNOW. We did that probably sometime this summer. And I don't know, the message really hung with me. And it's I feel like it's something that more people need to hear. And I feel like hopefully if I can deliver it to you today in a way that God leads me to. But first, let me talk about Moses today. It's the first person I'll be talking about. And I'll be reading from Exodus 4, 1 through 17. Now, to give you a little backstory before I start reading, this is when God comes to Moses with the burning bush and everything else. And to give you a little backstory, Moses is, I forget where he is, but he's in some other country. And he just fled Egypt. And Egypt, he had to flee Egypt because, well, first of all, he was a Hebrew. And at the time when he was a baby, his mama put him down the river in a basket because the Pharaoh at the time was killing all the babies, all the firstborn sons. And so he was put down the river, and Pharaoh's daughter found him. I wish this thing would work. And would found him. And she took him in and everything else, raised him as his own. And no one knew he was a Hebrew. Until he got later, he grew up and figured out he was, of course. And then he had to flee the country for a crime that he did. Now God's coming to him, and he's telling him that I need you to go back. And so here we're going to read Exodus 4, 1 through 17. Then Moses answered, "What if they won't believe me and will not obey me, but say the Lord did not appear to you?" And the Lord asked him, "What is it that in